Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over a few different ways to use the SUMPRODUCT formula in Microsoft Excel. Let me give you the final result of where we're going today. In my first example, we are going to do a SUMPRODUCT of the quantity and unit price over here. And then in our second example, we are going to show you how to use division with SUMPRODUCT. And at the end of this lesson, I'll have some bonus Excel training for you, so you might want to stick around for that. So let's look at our first example. So before we start, let's talk about what SUMPRODUCT is. SUMPRODUCT is taking this cell here and multiplying it by this value in here. And then adding this cell here and multiplying this value here and so on. So let me just show you really quickly in column D. If I were to type equals, cell B2, and an asterisk, and then cell C2, and hit enter, I can see I'm getting 3,000 because that's 300 times 10. And if I were to just autofill this formula all the way down, and then if I were to highlight all of these numbers, I can see down here that I'm going to get 20,050. And so that's what a SUMPRODUCT is, but that took an awful lot of steps to get there. So I'm going to delete that and click right here in F1. And I'm simply going to type equals sum product with a left parenthesis. And the first thing I'm going to be asked for is where is my first column of data? And I'm going to highlight everything I have in column B. And then I'm going to type a comma and I will be asked for a second array. And then I'm going to highlight what my prices are in column C. And then hit enter. And now you can see I did get 22,050, just like I did when I multiplied this by this, this by this, this by this, etc., and then summed them all up. So SUMPRODUCT is just a really quick way of doing that. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So for our second example, I wanted to show you that this does not only work with multiplication, but it also works with division. So if I were to come here and type equals sum product with a left parenthesis, and if I were to highlight my sales amount in column B, then type a divided sign, and then highlight my values in column C and hit enter, I'm getting 1200. Now, what is this 1200? Well, let's say I go over here and I say equals what's in cell B2 divided by what's in cell C2 and hit enter, use my autofill, and then down here I can see that my sum is 1200. So not only can I do a sum product where I'm multiplying numbers, but I can also do a sum product where I'm dividing numbers as well. So we have another example right here in example 3, where you can actually do a weighted average. And if you're interested in learning about the weighted average, you can visit our blog at the link below in the YouTube description and find out more there. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.